Hello guys, well, oh, I'm sorry, welcome back to my channel. So this is Ginger. So if you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, please subscribe to my channel and click the bell so that you will be notified for all my videos. And for today's video, I will be talking about rude, harsh, and strict students in native camp. If you're interested, please keep on watching. Alright guys, so actually I made this video after we ate dinner with our family. So Merry Christmas to everyone, to all the teachers there who are hardworking even though it's a holiday. Alright, so yeah, so for our topic now, I will be talking about rude, harsh, and strict students. Yes guys, I have experienced two harsh and strict students. So we'll be talking about first the first student that I've experienced. It was a lady. She came in my class last Tuesday. She chose free conversation in our class. So when she came in the class, she told me she was so tired, and it took me a lot of time, guys, to give her a topic I tried to look in, you know, the list of topics for advanced students, and every topic I will tell her, guys, she will not say yes. She keep on saying no, I don't like that topic, like that. And she even told me that I'm not paying attention to her, because when she came in the class, guys, she provided 6 requests. And there are a lot of, you know, avoid talking about my job, avoid talking about my interest, avoid talking about my hobbies. You should initiate to ask a question because you are the teacher. So when I look at those requests, I feel nervous because, you know, I feel that this student is rude, strict, and harsh. So for our topic, she agreed with technology. Not technology, cell phone radiation. So yeah, we talk about cell phones until the time that she left. So I feel relieved, guys, but I still don't like her. Yes, because she's really rude, she's harsh, she's like, you know, she's like acting as she knows more than me. So in the entire class, I did not it's like I only talk with like for a few minutes, and then she keeps on talking. So that's it, she's the one who's keep on talking during the class. Yeah, okay. For the next student, guys, on the the student was my last student last Tuesday. So on the next day, Wednesday, guys, I had another rude, harsh, and strict student. It was a guy. He was the first student. So I feel that this is not my lucky day again. So he was a guy, and when he came in the class, he speak too fast. And I told him, can you speak louder? Because I can't understand him, because his voice is... actually, guys, his sound was already maximum. Just already maximum, I click it higher. But his voice is really loud. And I asked him, if you don't mind, could you speak louder, please, so that I can hear you better? And he was angry. He told me, why do you need me to speak louder? I don't want to speak louder. He's really harsh, guys, and rude. So he told me to hurry up because he's in a hurry. So again, guys, I feel nervous again, and I don't know how to feel. Like, I'm a little like sad and angry because he was so harsh. I did not do anything bad, right? So yeah, but the good thing is he gave me a lot of topics. He provided his own topic, guys. So I just chose the topic, and he I asked topics, and he just he answered everything. So I did not speak a lot. He was the one who keep on talking in the entire class, the same with the woman before. So yeah, but you know, he told me that I am not paying attention because I did not hear anything he said. Guys, I cannot understand anything he said because he's very fast, and whenever I ask a request, he will be angry. So I just tried my best to listen to him, and I need to focus on, you know, in listening to him. So the bad thing, guys, because he keeps on talking and talking, I did not check the time. So when still he keep on talking and talking, the class ended and I did not say goodbye. Okay, so I did not say goodbye to him, guys. So what I did is I just put in the message that I'm sorry I was not able to say goodbye proper. I did not say goodbye because I did not check the time. So I'm hoping that he will not give me a bad rating. I mean, a low rating. So if ever I expected that he will give me a low rating because I did not check the time. But he said he was in a hurry. And I did not try to stop him because I don't want to interrupt him because I'm scared that he will be angry. Yes. Okay, so now I will give you tips on how to handle rude students. Okay, guys, so for the tips, first tip, guys, is you need to be confident, because they will, I mean, those kind of students, guys, will look at you, I mean, not look at you, like, they are going to test you if you are good enough for them to be their teacher. Okay, because if they feel that you're not confident, you are a weak teacher, so they will make you feel bad, like me. Okay, second, you need to be attentive all the time, because whenever they say something, you need to be attentive, because if they feel that you're not listening, they will be angry at you. Okay, and last tip, number three, you need to be patient. Yes, so you need to be patient, guys, because even though that you want to, you know, to end the class, but you shouldn't, because you're the teacher, so you should end the class well. Okay, and yeah, I have fourth, last one, you should be flexible as well. So you need to adjust yourself also if ever the student is rude. So you need to adjust yourself, right? Because so that they will not make you feel bad. Not like me, I really feel bad for those two students. Okay, so actually, guys, I was really shocked because it was my first time handling those kind of students. In my previous job, when I was still working in a Korean company, usually the rude students are kids. Their adults are really kind and friendly. But in native camp, I was shocked because there were rude students, adults. They're around like 40s or 50 years old. So it kind of made me feel bad because I thought those kind of students are, you know, kind and friendly. But we can never please everybody. Right, so we need to be ready, especially for newbies. So I think their target is really newbie teachers. Because I'm a newbie in native camp, it's still 1 month. I'm still 1 month in native camp. So they will try to, like, check if, you know, you're good, like that. So, yeah, guys. So you should be prepared all the time, and you should know how to handle those kind of students, because but you know, it's okay. After you handle those kind of students, you can just, you know, move on, and another good student will come. It's not all the time. Yeah, because I handled a lot of students already, but there were only two who are those kind of students. Okay, so yes guys, for those aspiring teachers as well, if you're interested to apply in Native Camp, please comment down below, and don't forget to like this video and click subscribe for to be updated, and click the notification bell to be notified with my new videos. So thank you so much guys for watching, and I hope I could still upload more videos. Okay, so Merry Christmas by the way, and arigato, goodbye, thank you so much.